to Jerushia Unscripted, the kickoff of the new series that will be coming out soon. Today, we're going to focus on Women's Month and women around the world that have made history. There were the forerunners that moved and shifted their country to heights that we can all only imagine. So join us as we sit at the table, we chat, and we have some wonderful dishes with my friends. Join me, Jerushia Unscripted. Okay, welcome back to Jerushia Unscripted. And we are here with my friends that I have asked to join me here at the Rendezvous. Did I say that correctly?
Rendezvous Wine and Bar.
Yes. Rendezvous Wine and Bar 48. This timeline covers the 3 years from 1848 to 1920, which includes the famed Women's Rights Convention in Seneca Falls, New York, the formation of a National American Women Suffrage Association, and the passage of the 19th Amendment to the Constitution, giving women the right to vote. And with that said, we're gonna move on to some of the women that each one of us wanna talk about. I'm gonna go to the right, and then I'm gonna go to my left, to my girl from the Philippines, Melanie. But my sister Susie, she wanted to spotlight some of her heroes.
As for me, I'm gonna start out with our present First Lady, Michelle Obama. Needless to say, she was born January, just like me, she's a Capricorn. January 17th, 1964. And her name initially was Michelle LaVon Robinson, and now she is Obama, and meaning she is married, our First Lady, to our present president, as well as he's our 44th president. I kind of wanted to touch on her because the things that she's contributed, first of all, she has been one of that whole couple has brought back the family. One of the things that we have found in a lot of our political situations, if you look back for the last couple of years where husbands were caught in infidelities, and it was just a mess. But we had a president and a first lady that continued to keep the family strong. Michelle Obama's mother, you know, they say it takes a tribe to raise a family, a village to raise a family.
That's right.
Her mother, you don't see her, but her mother is at the White House and she's helping to rear and keep those children in the right direction.
Yes.
The whole thing being is that they wanted to bring back the family unit.
And I think that's really important.
Yeah.
It's very important, and that's what this show is about.
Right.
Not to interrupt you. The power of a woman and our roles as women.
Exactly.
Not only within our home, but in the community.
Yes.
You know, I am a firm believer God has given us a gift that we must discover that hidden treasure in us.
Yes.
And we're going to talk more about that, but before I do, I want to go to my left with Miss Melody, my diva from the Philippines. She's going to give us a little education. She's going to educate us on some of the heroes from the Philippines, and then I'll come back to you.
That's fine.
You know, I want to make sure we all get, we want to know about all these unsung heroes we need to know about, which is, we stand on their shoulders.
Exactly.
They prepare the way for us.
Yes.
Okay?
Thank you so much. And in fact, you know, you had mentioned that in the 1970s were, or not 1970s, it was in the 1940s or such, where they had the revolution or where they were able to empower the women. And in fact, in the Philippines, it began with during the martial law era, where the Filipinas were actually given the presidential decree by the former president Ferdinand Marcos, mm-hmm. and that was on January 7, 1975, mm-hmm. where the Filipino woman, created a commission for them to be able to have a role in the Philippines, and they had an association or a proclamation that was called the Philippine Commission on Women.
Mm-hmm.
And what happens is during that decree, the Filipino women were able to promote economic, social, mm. political empowerment of the women in the Philippines, and also to review and implement laws regarding women.
Yeah.
So that happened in the martial law era,
mm.
and it's amazing. But since, you know, as far as this history of the heroes of the Philippines. It started out in the 1700s, where we have one of our first heroes. Her name is Gabriela Carino Silang. So she was one of the first national heroes of the Philippines. And then, of course, it goes on from there. We actually have one of the first Filipino president in the Philippines, and that was President Corazon Aquino, who became the first president of the Philippines. And since then, we've actually had two Filipino presidents, Filipinas, I would say, presidents in the Philippines. So aside from the political backgrounds of them showing their strength and the family within the Filipino culture, because family is very, very strong in our culture, it's nice to see that women can lead a country.
If she can actually, if a woman can run a house,
absolutely,
she can lead a country.
Right.
We have, do you think, I'm going to ask you ladies, what do you think? Do you think we're going to have a female president in the United States?
Wow.
Ooh, yeah, that's a good question.
What do you think? I mean, we've got a lot of crazies out there right now.
Oh my goodness.
You may want to poop that, leap that, but you know, this is Jerushia Unscripted. But you know, when you really look at the competition of what's going on, I think it's time for a woman to take the lead here in America. We had our first African-American president. So I would think to follow his footsteps, it would be, prophetically, I believe it will be a woman to show that it's time for change. And that woman can get the house in order. Our house needs to get in order here in America. What do you think? Her kid's grown, she's got a grandchild, she's handled various parts in the White House. So now, as far as I'm concerned, it's time for her to take her rightful position, because she knows how to work every aspect in the political scene now.
And not to mention, she was married. We're talking about
former president.
We're talking about Clinton.
That's
Hillary
right.
Clinton, and she was married to Bill Clinton.
Right.
So again, you know, speaking of infidelities, but the bottom line being is still, she still held the family together, and she was persecuted because she kept her family even in the face of being scrutinized even herself for staying with him after knowing that they had said that he had an infidelity.
Has a child, he has some proof, but that's the power of a woman.
Well, that's what I'm saying. She kept the family unit still together.
Exactly.
You know, there's a song. What's that song? It says, "I can bring on the bacon, stir it up in a pan."
That's
and she's
commercial.
Got on a suit. Well, there's a song,
right,
the actual
right.
song.
Oh,
right.
Yes.
And she's got on a suit. She's got her briefcase. She's done her business outside the home. And when she comes home, the thing with the woman is we never stop. We don't stop even when we close our eyes and go to sleep. You're thinking when you go to bed about what you got to get up and the acts you have to perform the next day.
And a homemaker is one of the most difficult things they can do, because as a homemaker, I mean, I'm a businesswoman and you both are as well. But as a homemaker, you're really working 24 hours a day.
Absolutely.
You have no vacations. You know, you're serving not only one master, which is your husband, but you're also serving your children.
Yes. That's
so
true.
You know, being able to, I would say that's the power in the woman, and
really
being
is.
Able to multitask.
Yes.
I don't know that many men that can multitask. It's very, very rare, but in a woman, I think it's in our nature. It's in our nature, and we're built to be able to hold down the fort and lead.
That's right.
You know, so yes, as far as going back to your question, I don't know, because I don't want to say what my political views are.
Right. You don't have to.
But as far as a woman leading a country, or any man leading a country, I would like to see the president lead from their heart.
Right.
You know, and that's the most important thing. I think when the people see the your kindness in your heart, and your heart can be as powerful. You don't have to be abrupt, but show power coming from your heart. And so
and that gentle spirit
that we
hold as women.
Yeah.
Some of us.
Yeah.
And if you think about it, even in England, how long has there been a woman reigning over a country? And whoever our next president is going to be, same thing. They've got to reign the country.
Yes.
We were talking about, you said, do we think it's going to be a female? Again, we want to leave that open. You know why? Because we're going to be getting together again.
Yeah.
And the key to it is, once we start building that, we want the momentum to speak for itself.
Yeah.
Well, I wanted to spotlight women, and that is what this whole month is.
Yeah.
This is the month of March. honoring and saluting women of courage, saluting women that have paved the way, like Harriet Tubman, Mary McBoone, so many, Oprah Winfrey.
Shirley Chisholm.
Some of ours from the slave descendants that had moved on. Also, I have to give props to a mighty woman that is from Liberia, president-elect. She is an American, African-American woman that moved to Liberia, because a lot of people don't know, from slavery after the emancipation and all of that, a lot of African-Americans, some of them went back to Liberia. They returned to Liberia, and she was one. And so the country is going through a lot of turmoil with butt-naked killing and kids killing. This woman came in, and I'm telling you, she has changed this country. And I think we all can learn from her in every village and every nation, because as you said, Melanie, she leads by her heart.
Yes.
She gets out in the midst of the villagers where she lived with the poor people, and she listens. I think that is a key, and we women have that key.
Yes.
Sometimes I think, and I know we're talking about women, but I don't want to get off too much, with political things, sometimes as men, they talk a lot. But we women are doers.
Absolutely.
We're doers in our home.
I agree.
We do it in our churches.
Yes.
We build churches.
Absolutely.
The man comes and he delivers the word. The woman is the one that builds the churches.
Yes.
You know, businesses, same thing.
Yes.
Corporate offices, it's the woman.
Yes. And we're the ones that keep it afloat.
Yeah.
A lot of times the man will have the idea, a basic idea, but we put everything into action. And then we keep it not only afloat, because if you really look at businesses, if they say behind every great man there's a woman.
That's
well,
right.
I beg to differ.
Oh.
Behind every great man, there's also an amazing, strong woman.
Yes.
You know, there
true.
Is a difference
there. Yes,
there is. I want to talk about a woman that that still today takes my breath. And today I'm going to speak about my sister. I'm going to speak about this woman here. Look at her; she's a little shocked. She didn't know I was going to go there.
That was shocked.
I'm going to speak when we talk about a woman that. Went to Africa.
Amazing.
You went to Africa with, she went to Africa with no idea what she was going there. She just was being sent with a mandate on her life. And this is what we're talking about with women. We had all these women that we wanted to talk about. But while we're sitting here, I think the first thing we need to do, because you're sitting at the head of the table, is I'd like to address Jerushia McDonald Hilton. And I'll tell you, starting out, I'm her sister, yes. And I can give you a funny little story to start it out, to let you know that this woman has been breaking the ceiling and breaking windows for as many years as I can remember. When we were young,
we had a window, a big wall
basically that was like a window, and my mother had our chest there. And this one, Jerusha used to always sit on there, and she would say, I am the queen of the, well, she fell out the window while she was doing this. So speaking of breaking the ceiling, she's been doing it all of her life. But I want to get on the part that makes this so interesting. She was given a Band-Aid, and out of nowhere, matter of fact, I was going to go with her, and then God told her I couldn't go. And I was really happy about that because I know her. So she goes to Africa, and she goes and lives in the bush. I mean, if you don't know what the bush is, she was sleeping on dong beds. That's
not dong beds. They sleep on mats, just like Asian people.
Yes,
but
they don't have mats.
But it had the dong and everything around it. Am I correct?
No.
To seal it up.
They're mats, just like, you know, they're made out of the straw.
The straw.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, like
so
the
about.
The
they
floor,
sleep on that. But go ahead. You know about that. Right?
So the whole thing being is, here it is, a young lady that grew up in Las Vegas, Nevada, the entertainment capital of the world. She's always been, I must say, she's always been one of those who will break a ceiling. But I'll say to you that she goes to Africa, and I talk to her every single solitary day. And my reason for doing that is because I was not allowed to physically go with her, but I could keep her strong because you get connected because she didn't hear about children being burned up or naked or the abuse and the AIDS and all of that. And again, I wanted to talk about Sonia Sotomayor. She's the first Latin of the United States Supreme Court. I wanted to talk about other women, but then I was it was an aha moment. I said, we've talked about all these women. A lot of them are not here right now. And I know she's kind of looking at me like, what are you doing? But I want to address that because today we have women that are fighting that you don't even know about. You have women that are going to break the ceilings and cross the barriers that we necessarily don't want to go.
Well, the thing is, can I interrupt you?
Go ahead.
I think it's very important. You know, it's real hard for me to hear people talk about me. I think it's really important, especially for Women's Month, that we take the time to reflect.
Mm-hmm.
And then to reflect in. Or of a woman. And we need to connect with that, because one thing I've learned, we women don't have any identity aside from our father and our husbands. If we don't have a husband, it's a lot of women walking around that have no name. And they have no head.
Yes.
Because the man represents the head.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so you see a lot of women very promiscuous at this time.
Yes.
And willing to die just to say they have a man.
Yes.
Or someone's husband.
Absolutely.
So we're not only dishonoring ourselves, but we're dishonoring our other queens.
That's right.
It's time for us to rise up as women and begin to honor each other as women. As healers, as incubators of life, as deliverers, and as movers and shakers. And I believe it's going to be us. And I believe it's going to start with this show, Jerushia Unscripted, because we're going to use this as a platform to unite all cultures, dialogue, and also show you how we're being robbed of our native tongue.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes. Thank you so much. And in fact, you know, you had mentioned that in the 1970s were, or not 1970s, it was in the 1940s or such, where they had the revolution or where they were able to empower the women. And in fact, in the Philippines, it began with, during the martial law era, where the Filipinas were actually given the presidential decree by the former president, Ferdinand Marcos, and that was on January 7, 1975, where the Filipino woman, it was created a commission for them to be able to have a role in the Philippines, and they had an association or a proclamation that was called the Philippine Commission on Women.
Closing out now, you'll see them bringing in the music. It's time to get their dance on. Again, this is a live Texas show, and it is real TV right here in Las Vegas, Nevada, the desert place where desert babies are born and eagles soar. You've been listening for the last hour to Jerushia Unscripted with co-host Susie Lane McDonald, as well as my Filipina diva, Melody.